On April 14, 2023, the Canadian Pacific Railway and the Kansas City Southern Lines Railroad merged to form CPKC Rail. To celebrate the railroad's first anniversary, CPKC President and CEO Keith Creel announced the Final Spike Steam Tour that would run from Calgary, Alberta, Canada, all the way to Mexico City and back, making stops in Moose Jaw, Minot, St. Paul, Franklin Park, Davenport, Kansas City, Shreveport, and Laredo. Leading the train was Canadian Pacific's Pride and Joy steam locomotive, H-1B Hudson No. 2816, fittingly named the Empress. In this video, we will chase the elegant Hudson on the former Dakota, Minnesota, and Eastern Railroad along the Mississippi River. First, we will chase the train from Davenport, Iowa, all the way to Ottumwa, Iowa. Next, we will catch up with it in Kansas City, Missouri, and Silvis, Illinois for its display events. And finally, we will chase it out of Davenport, Iowa, up along the Mississippi River, and ending the chase in Marquette, Iowa. This would easily become the biggest steam event of the decade. This is the CPKC 2816 Final Spike Steam Tour, the Royal Steam Queen in the Midwest. It's Thursday, May 9th, 2024, and CP2816 is pulling into Davenport, Iowa, coming from Bensonville, Illinois. It's on its way to the CPKC Nahant Yard to spend the night for its next display event here in Davenport. We catch it here at the modern Woodman Park Baseball Stadium as it creeps through downtown heading for the yard. Thank you. It's now May 10th, 2024, and we're back in Davenport, Iowa, on the edge of the CPKC Nahant yard, waiting for 2816 to pull back into the yard after going on display in downtown. A little after 5:30, and the Empress's headlight appears through the trees and slowly pulls into the yard. After watching it pull into the Nahant yard, we went to our hotel to get some shut-eye for the next day. It's now Saturday, May 11th, 2024, and we're back in the CPKC Nahant yard, waiting for 2816 to depart on the next leg of its tour to Kansas City, Missouri. Before the train could depart, though, a CPKC switching movement would take place with the KCSM ACE as power. After the yard switcher got done with its work, the dispatcher gave 2816 permission to leave the yard. After seeing it at the Nahant Yard, the chase was on. We first catch it here in a small town along the Mississippi River called Buffalo, Iowa.
Do you? Hey, you want to stand right here and I'll get your picture of the train behind you?
We then chased the train down to Muscatine, Iowa, where it would make a small whistle stop. Not long after arriving in Muscatine, 2816 was back on the move. Our next stop on the chase was in the small town of Letts, Iowa. In Washington, Iowa, the train made a service stop for lubrication. After 30 minutes, the train proceeded through the town, passing the historic Milwaukee Road Depot. We then catch the train again just outside of the small town of Farson, Iowa. We then come into the town of Ottumwa, Iowa, where we catch the train again at the State Highway 23 crossing. After crossing the Atumwa Diamond, 2816 then pulls into the Atumwa Yard for servicing. As things weren't exciting enough, a CPKC mixed freight rolled by with KCS 4009 leading. After the lubrication was finished, 2816 departed Atumwa Yard on its final leg to Kansas City. Our final stop on the chase was at a small private crossing in the farm country area known as Willard, Iowa. After catching it in Willard, we called it a day, but the chase would continue. It's now Saturday, May 18th, 2024, and we're in Kansas City, Missouri, where we see the Empress on display for the final Spike Steam Tour event here at Kansas City Union Station. Displayed right next to it is CPKC ES44AC number 9375. The very first locomotive painted in CPKC's new paint scheme. There were a lot of activities to do at the event, including the Union Station's model train exhibit, riding the miniature trains around the property, and even touring CPKC's own museum car.
Thank you. then we're talking to one of our pastors, and my mentor pastor led him to Christ up here in the Easter.
What's this guy? He got baptized on Easter. So
these are just, this is part of the history of the Wayne Street River.
And with that, our chase of the southbound run of the Final Spike Steam Tour concludes. Thanks for watching part 1 of my chase of CP2816 and the Final Spike Steam Tour on the southbound run through Iowa. Tune in for part 2, which will be premiering tomorrow at 5:00 p.m. Central Time. If you want to watch part 2 or other videos of mine, make sure to subscribe and click the bell for notifications so you won't miss a video from me. And if you haven't already, make sure to give this video a like, share it with your friends, and leave a comment. Anyways, this is Trainboy 1522 Productions, signing off.